you can win $32,000 on the turn of a card on Card Shark. And if you play your cards right, you can win this beautiful car. And now, the host of Card Shark, Bob Eubanks.
Thank you. Thank you, Gene Wood. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Card Shark. Nice to have you with us today. We have a lot of money to give away. We also have this brand new car to give away. And we have two very delightful Card Sharks. We'll meet them in just a moment. First of all, the two ladies who help me out every morning, we couldn't do it without them. And here they are, our dealers on Card Sharks. They are Lacey Pemberton and Susanna Williams.
Good morning. Hi.
We will start from the beginning today.
Okay.
All right,
good.
While you're getting the cards ready, let's meet our Card Sharks, our champion and our challenger.
Hello.
Hello. Janos.
Yes.
$3,075.
Yes, that's what I've got so far. My name is...
I know that, yes. That's why I said you have $3,075. Were you questioning me?
Not in the least. I was going to tell you a little bit about myself.
Why don't you do that?
My name is János Bene, and born in Hungary, and I was lucky enough as a junior in college to spend a year abroad and lived in Paris for that year.
Now, how long have you been here? I don't speak English
In the United States in 68, but we lived in Montreal from 57 to 68.
So where'd you learn to speak English?
In Canada.
In Canada?
Yeah, in Montreal.
Did you have trouble learning English?
No, it came very easily. Just kind of pick it up.
But Hungarian's very difficult, isn't it?
To learn. If you haven't learned it as a youngster, it's very difficult to learn.
Well, I don't hear much of an accent. That's great.
None at all, since I've been speaking different languages since I was 2.5, but I still speak Hungarian with my parents at home.
How many languages do you speak?
3. French, English, and Hungarian.
That's wonderful. Yeah, that's great. I have trouble with this here language that we here speak. Yeah. Hi, Colleen.
Hi, Bob. My name's Colleen Wiley. I'm a housewife that stays at home with an 8-month-old son named Dan the Man.
Dan the Man.
Yeah.
That's your son? That's funny. Is he a little devil?
Yeah, that's what he is.
All right. Okay, nice to have you with us, Colleen.
Thanks.
You know how to play the game, I hope. First player to win 2 games, wins the championship, goes on to play for the big money. Lacey's got the cards all dealt out, and we're on our way. Here we go. Question number 1 in our first game. Janos is yours. It involves our 14-year-old girls who are with us this week, and there they are. Now, Janos, before the show, we asked these 10 girls, right now, do you have a crush on a guy who hardly even knows you exist? How many of these 10 girls said, yeah, they do?
Boy, since they're so pretty, I think that the young man they'd have a crush on would certainly notice. But I remember when I was 14...
Well, you're a silver-tongued devil,
aren't
you?
Especially with 14-year-olds. I know when I was young, there was always somebody that I cared for that didn't care for me. So I think that's... actually, kind of a middle number, right? Let me just go with 5.
5 of them. All right. Colleen, what do you think?
Well, I am a 14-year-old girl inside. I am not grown up yet. And I always had a crush on somebody, always, and they never knew I was alive. The people I didn't like.
Do you still?
No, I'm married now.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Yeah, it's kind of hard when you're married. So I think I'm going to say that's a little bit higher.
A little bit higher than that. Well,
a little bit.
The actual number of these girls who have a crush on a guy who hardly knows they exist is... 9 of them.
Yay!
Wow. I guess it's kind of fun, though. Raise your hand, 9 ladies. Those of you who have a crush on a guy, Tiffany, this guy doesn't know anything about it?
No.
Are you going to tell him?
No.
Why?
He's in my PE class, and we get to wear these cute little shorts, and it's, like, really nice.
He'll know, Tiffany. Trust me, he'll know. All right, ladies, thank you very much. Nice to have you with us. Isn't that fun? I never had any PE classes with girls.
No, I didn't.
I mean, really? Okay,
no boys,
we've got
no
the. Colleen has it. All right, Colleen, here's your card. 9.
Change
Wanna change it?
It?
Yeah. 9 is a 3.
Oh, all right. Good. Higher.
Is it higher than the 3? You bet it is.
Lower.
The queen is lower, yeah.
Higher
than the 5. Here we go. Back to the 3 we go. Janos, you're playing free. Off
okay.
This card. There's your card 10.
I will go lower.
Is it lower? Yep.
And higher.
Higher than a 5. How about a king?
And lower, please.
Lower again. 10.
I'm going to freeze.
Freeze there. Okay. I don't blame him. Okay. 1 card away from winning this game. We'll pause for these words, and we'll be right back with more Card Sharks right after this.
This week in game show history, Star Trek's George Takei and husband boldly go on the Newlywed Game. They win 10 grand for the Japanese American National Museum, and later he wins the Medal of Honor for his work as a humanitarian. Way to go, Sulu.
There has never...
The
Today, starting at noon, Buzzr is the place to play with our most popular shows. That's why daytime is playtime.
Every day you must watch.
Today, starting at noon Eastern, only on Buzzr. Let's play.
Welcome back to Card Shark. Now, let's continue with game number one between Giannis and Colleen. And Colleen, this is your question. Here it is. We surveyed 100 marriage counselors, and we asked them, generally speaking, is a marriage more likely to be successful if one partner is clearly the boss? How many marriage counselors said yes, a marriage is more likely to be successful if one partner is clearly the boss?
Well, I'm married, and I'm clearly the boss.
Are you really?
Clearly. My husband is not here.
If he was here, would you clearly be the boss?
Yeah, he can't get me now. So.
Well, wouldn't you hate to meet her in a courtroom? Whoa.
So, I'm going to say that, that's probably got to be a pretty high number, because if you have too much competition, you're going to have all kinds of problems. Someone's got to stand ahead. So I'm going to say 67.
67 out of 100 marriage counselors said yes. A marriage is more likely to be successful if one partner is clearly the boss. Giannis, higher or lower than 67?
I think it's going to be more successful if there's one person in charge, simply because there won't be all that conflict, there won't be too much fighting going on. But I still think it's going to be a little bit lower than that.
I think it might be lower than that? Well, the actual number of marriage counselors who said a marriage is more likely to be successful if one partner is the boss is 10 of them. Yes, it was lower. All right.
What was it, Lord?
Giannis, the 10 is yours.
Oh, let's change that card, please.
You bet. See what Lacey has for you. 10 becomes an 8.
Oh, much better.
Isn't that great?
Let's go ahead and go lower, please.
Lower. All right, if it's lower, you win game number one. Is it lower than the 8? No, it is not lower than the 8. And that means that, Colleen, you're playing free off the 3.
Higher.
Higher.
Gotta go higher.
Is it?
Yep. Have to go lower.
Lower than the queen. Here's your 6.
Higher, Bob.
Higher again, the lady says.
No.
Take the deck and burn it. I was helping you out. We're going to burn that deck.
Yeah, thank you. Good. Get rid of it.
Here's a question for you. This is an educated guess question. Today, the average American woman has about 2 kids. In the year 1800, how many children did the average American woman have?
I would think it's certainly more than that, since there's birth control now and people are more conscious of population getting out of hand. So, a lot of people aren't having kids anymore either. So I'd say back then, average woman had 4.5. No, I have to give a whole number, don't I? How about 4?
I wonder how you get a half. I've been called a half wit. So you say 4, right?
4 kids.
All right. Colleen, higher or lower than 4?
Oh, I'm going to say higher. I think they had bigger families. I only have 1 now, but...
Because they had to work in the fields and such.
They needed more kids. Those farmhands.
The actual number of children the average American woman had in the year 1800 is 7. It was higher. All right, interesting question. Colleen, again, you have the 3, and I assume you want to hang on to it.
Higher.
Higher. Here we go. Yep.
Lower.
Lower than the jack. It is. Remember the old 6, don't you? Higher than the 6? No. Burned you again, didn't it? Okay.
I hate that.
You're playing
card.
Free from the 8, Giannis.
Higher.
Higher. Is it higher? If it is, you win the first game. You
Yay!
Do.
Better than you don't think.
Another $100 for you. Okay, so the first game goes to our champion. Colleen, that means you've got to win this game. It's really important to you in order to stay in this thing. So let's start game number 2 right now. Lacey will deal out the cards from the same deck, and we are on our way. Colleen, the question is yours. We surveyed 100 bachelors, and we asked them, have you ever fallen for the mother of a girl you were dating?
Ooh.
How many bachelors admitted they've fallen for their date's mom?
I don't know about that one, Bob. That's pretty tough.
I didn't write this one.
Well, I'm just going to take a wild guess and say 48.
48 out of 100 bachelors have fallen for the girl's mom.
No.
Giannis has that funny look in his eye. Giannis, have you done this?
Not recently, no.
That's what I thought.
No, I think that it's going to be a little bit lower, since if you're going to be designated a bachelor, you're probably older than 20 or 25. By that time, the girl's mom's going to be pretty old in relation to you. No offense to
anybody. I mean, she could be 30, you know what I mean? Yeah.
At least, yeah. Right. So I'm going to say a little lower, I hope.
The actual number of bachelors who have fallen for their date's mother is 12 of them. Yes, it was a lot lower. Okay. All right, Giannis. This time, your card's a queen. That's a good one.
Oh, good. Let's go lower, please.
Lower. You bet it is.
And higher?
Higher than the 4. Here we go.
And lower?
Lower again. No.
It's getting funny now. Colleen, you're playing free. This is yours. 10.
Lower.
Lower, you say?
Yeah.
All right. Is it lower? You bet it is.
Higher.
Higher. Got it.
Lower.
Lower. She's going on. Lower than the 9. Yes. But look what you have.
I hate that car bomb. Higher. This time it's got to be higher this time. It has to be.
If it's higher than the 6, you win the game. We'll play a tiebreaker game. Be higher than the 6? No. 3 times in a row, the 6 burns the lady. Why don't we pause? What do you think about that? And we'll be back with more Card Sharks right after this.
Today.
Welcome back to Card Sharks, and we are in the middle of game number 2. Time to find out who our champion is going to be, and let's go right on to it. Janos, here's a question, educated guess question. What's the oldest you can be to join the Army? The oldest you can be to join the Army.
I don't have any idea. I'll just go ahead and say 35.
35. Colleen, will it be higher or lower than 35?
I'm going to say lower.
Lower, you think? Well, let's find out. The oldest you can be to join the Army is 34. You're right. It was. See, there is an advantage of being old. You know what I mean? All right. Colleen, you got a 10. You want to play or change?
I think I'll change it. Can't hurt, right?
Okay. Lacey has for you now a 4. A
little higher.
Better. Is it higher? Yeah.
Lower.
Lower than the 10. Yes.
Higher.
Higher than the deuce. Yes.
Lower.
Lower than the jack in order to win the game. Yeah. Tied it up. Good for you.
Unbelievable.
At least there were no 6s.
I don't want to see another 6 forever.
You're in good shape. Okay, that means we have to play a tiebreaker game because first person to win 2 games is the champ. We'll deal this time. Lacey will deal out only 3 cards. We'll have a maximum of 3 high-low questions. The first question is for Colleen, and it involves our 10, 14-year-old ladies in our studio audience. There they are.
Yay.
Now, Colleen, before the show, we asked these 10 girls if you could choose either to be Miss America or to be the first lady astronaut on the moon. Would you choose to be Miss America? How many of these 10 girls said yes, they would choose to be Miss America?
Well, I have a 12-year-old sister, so this is a little bit younger than you guys, but I know she always talks about going on the space shuttle and being an astronaut.
She's spaced out.
I guess so, yeah. You could
just
say
kidding.
That. And you guys look really ambitious. And although it'd be great to be Miss America, you can be beautiful and an astronaut, right? So, can you repeat that?
Yes. What you said was you could be beautiful
no,
and
what I said.
Oh, not what you. Oh, I'm sorry. How many of these 10 girls said yes, they would choose to be Miss America rather than an astronaut?
Oh, that's going to be pretty. I'm going to say 3.
3 of them. All right. Got us. Higher or lower than 3?
Boy, with all the movies about space flight and all these things, I think more than would choose to be the first woman astronaut on the moon. And could you repeat the question again, too? I'm lost. Now, how many would choose to be Miss America?
Yes.
Lower. Lower than 3.
Lower than 3. Yeah. You guys are funny. The actual number of these girls who would rather be Miss America is 1. It was lower. Yes. Okay. So we have 9 astronauts and 1 Miss America. Who's the Miss America down there? And it's Laura. All right, Laura. Thank you. Thank you, ladies, very much. Here we go. Tiebreaker game. Janos, there's a deuce.
Oh, wonderful. Higher.
Higher than the deuce.
Oh, I don't believe it.
No. Colleen, you're playing free. Here's your card. 3.
Higher.
Higher than the 3. King. If it's lower, you're the new champ.
Mom, I want to go home.
Unbelievable.
Let's just stop this show and go home. What do you think? Okay, let's try another question. You ready? Janos, this is yours.
I'm ready, I think.
I'm sure glad this is you, not me. Yeah. We surveyed 100 people. We asked them, do you have a relative who's a millionaire? How many people said they do have a relative who is a millionaire?
Didn't we go through this once before?
Yeah, Rolls Royce.
Yeah, that's right. Boy, there's a lot of millionaires, but not that many. I'm not going to think that's a real high number. I certainly don't have any relatives that are. So out of 100, I'd say, 24 are going to say.
24 out of 100 say they have a relative that's a millionaire. Colleen, what do you think? Higher or lower than that?
Well, I wish I knew some relatives that were millionaires, but I don't. I would have to say lower.
Even lower, you say. The actual number of people who have a relative who's a millionaire is 21. Yes, it was lower. Just a little bit lower. Okay, Colleen, the 3 again.
Higher.
Higher than the 3, 10.
Lower.
Lower. If it's lower, you're the new champ. Are you the new champ? Yes, you are.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Oh, congratulations to you, Colleen.
Thanks.
Yeah, no, so you ended up with $3,175, and you earned every dime of it.
I know, didn't I?
Nice to see you. Thanks for being with us. Okay, Colleen, right over here.
All right.
You know, our new champ is Colleen. In a moment, she's going to have a chance to win thousands of dollars, a new car, and lots of fun. We'll be right back for that.
Have you ever...
Welcome back to Card Sharks. Colleen is our champion, and now the fun is really going to begin. Boy, that was a tough match, though, you were involved in. You've got $200, but we've got thousands of dollars over there to give away. Also, we've added a couple of jokers to the deck anytime a joker pops up. Well, that means that you'll have another chance at winning this beautiful car. It's really a pretty car, too. And just for winning the match, Lacey has one joker for you, so you know you at least have one chance of winning that car. So we're going to start you off with $200. Remember, you can change one card per line. If you're ready, here we go. Let's win some money,
okay.
Colleen. We're on our way. First card is a 10. Player 10.
Change it.
Change it which one?
One. Number one.
Number one. Let's see what the 10 becomes. Thank you, Susanna. The 10 is now a joker. All right. There. Lacey can add that to her collection. Still want to change it? Which one you want this time?
Two.
Number two. There you go. Okay. 10 is a 9. Now you got to play and you got $200.
$50 lower.
$50. Lower than the 9 it is. You got $250.
$100 higher.
$100. Higher than the 4. Yes. Now you've got $350.
$50 lower.
$50 lower than the 8. No, it is not, but that's all right. You got $300. Come up here. Give you another $400. You got $700.
Change
the 9.
It with the 1.
Number 1. She wants to change. Okay, good cards now. Come on.
Come on.
9. Now you're a 5.
Oh, that's
700.
Sweet. $350 higher.
Higher than the 5. It's all right. Push. No win, no loss. You're fine shape.
Okay. $350 higher again.
$350 higher again. Is it higher than the 5? It is not. Now you're at $350 with the 3.
$300 higher.
$300 higher than the 3. There's a queen. $650. Queen is your card, and you got to bet at least half of it.
$600 lower.
$600 lower. Sure. $600 lower than the queen. There. So. You got $1,250.
I'm great.
Not bad for a half hour's work.
No, it isn't.
Okay, you're doing fine. Actually, you're $1,450. But I think what's fun is that Lacey now has two jokers for you. Hang on to those two jokers, because if you find the car over there, this is the car you're going to win. Gino?
It's a brand new Pontiac. The Sunbird SE Coupe, the road machine that's practical enough to keep your budget from intruding on your fun. From Pontiac. Okay, Bob?
Okay, Gene, thank you very much. Colleen, we'd love to see you win that car. Behind one of those seven cars that Susanna has for you is the word car. Go find it. You'll go home in that car. Number two, number five, the lady says. I got a good feeling for you.
Come on. I do, too.
Let's do it. Okay.
Come on, Bob.
What's behind number two? Behind number two is the word car. You are the winner. That brings your winnings to $10,000 so far. Okay, that's come.
All right. Oh, my God.
$10,013 you're winning so far. The car's here. Let's come right down here if we can. Oh, this is all wonderful. Our champ wins the car. You got the cash. And you're still the champ. Wipe those big tears. There you go. And go over there and stand where the champion stands.
All right.
And Marcia, please come in here. Things have turned around.
Yeah,
that's great. Marcia, how are you?
Hi, I'm fine, Bob.
Well, tell us all about yourself.
My name is Marcia Carter. I was born in Massachusetts. I live here now, and I'm an accounts payable clerk.
An accounts payable clerk. Mm-hmm. Well, we hope you'll go home some money so you have lots to pay. All right, you know how to play the game,
yes,
I assume?
I do.
Fine. Then Lacey's going to deal out the cards, and let's get going right away. You got to win two games in order to win the car like she did and also win the money. Colleen, this is your question. We surveyed 100 women. We asked them, would you rather have a beautiful face than a beautiful body? How many women said they would rather have a beautiful face?
Bob, my life is a diet body. And I'm going to say a lot of them, maybe 67.
Would rather have a beautiful face?
No.
How many women said they would rather have a beautiful face?
30.
30 of them. Marcia, higher or lower than 30?
I think that's going to be higher. I think it's easier to fluctuate your body, but your face...
Costs a lot of money.
Yes. A lot of money.
Ask me. The actual number of women who would rather have a beautiful face is 63 of them. You're right, Marcia, it was higher. And Marcia, welcome to our show. Here's your... Oh, hello, Bob. Here's your card. It's a 4. You can play or change it.
Let's go higher, Bob.
Higher than the 4. There's an ace.
Let's go lower.
Lower than the ace. How about a 6?
Freeze
on the 6. Okay. She'll freeze right there. We'll pause right here. We'll be back with more Card Sharks right after this. Welcome back to Card Sharks. We are going to have to pause and pick it up next time where we are right now. You girls are telling secrets, and I don't know anything about it. For Lacey, Susanna, Gina, and the whole gang, I'm Bob Eubanks saying we're going to find out, and I'll tell you later what this is all about. See you at Card Sharks. So long.
Some of our departing contestants will receive a travel cosmetic bag, a new Active Length Lee Press-On Nails Beautify Active Hands. Press-On in seconds, Active Length Lee Press-On Nails. An LCD timer and take the fat out of frying, reduce calories with Mazola No Stick, the only cooking spray made with pure Mazola corn oil. A silver serving tray and Bayer, the more you read, the more you hear, the more you'll know why Bayer is the wonder drug that works wonders. A travel alarm and Prego spaghetti sauces, original Prego, thick and chunky Prego Plus, and now fresh tasting Prego Al Fresco. Homemade taste, it's in there. A calculator and Tootsie Pops, the only pop with a real Tootsie Roll center and Tootsie Rolls. The chocolatey candy bar that lasts a long time. A manicure set and fast-effective Q-Tex remover. It actually locks in moisture so your nails get stronger every time you use it. And a member of our studio audience will receive Hamilton's Rose Ladies Diamond Dress Watch. 12 diamonds set on round case switch, fourth movement. Adjustable mesh bracelet from Hamilton. This is Gene Wood speaking for Card Sharks, a Mark Goodson television production.